We have a very special guest. He's a skilled trades guy, passionate about cooking, obviously, runner-up on MasterChef Canada on TV, and he's going to be cooking up a storm right for you, and he's got food for lots of people. So let's have some fun. Let's big hand of applause. Let's hear it for Jeremy. There you go. Who's signing autographs right now, and he will be doing that after the show also. Okay? So that was a rehearsal. Let's try it again. Ladies and gentlemen, the runner-up from MasterChef Canada, Chef Jeremy!
Thank you. Hey guys, how's it going? Okay, so who's ready to eat?
Me!
I have 80 portions, so hopefully there'll be enough for all of you guys. I do need three people to come up on stage to help me. Those three people will be the first to eat. Okay, you? I'll take you. I'll take you too. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna teach you guys how to roll a traditional lumpia, okay? So lumpia is the Filipino version of egg rolls. And it comes in different forms. Typically, it's usually just pork and carrots wrapped in an egg roll wrapper. So my version is a pork belly, bean sprout, cabbage, and yam egg rolls. And then we're also gonna do a couple of fun interactive things. I'm gonna show you guys how to do and make a caviar. So any type of liquid you can think of, orange juice, apple juice, soy sauce, hot sauce, you can make it into caviar. So I don't know if you guys can see this. I've already made some. I'm gonna teach you guys how to make it, and it's super easy. Okay, so first of all, let me try to set one of you guys up here. Okay, so let's start with Eve. This is Eve, guys. Everybody give her a round of applause. Okay, so let's start with this. Okay. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna fill it with the filling. So like I said, it's carrots, yams, pork belly, and bean sprouts, right? So, first thing you gotta do is take this and fold it up and over. Use your hand to sandwich it back like that. You can use two hands. You can do this and go like that, right? Okay, and then take these two corners and fold it like that. And fold it up and over, right? And then use your fingers to kind of give it a roll over. Right? Okay, stop right there. Wet your fingers a little bit and wet the tip. Okay, and then every time you roll it, you want to pull it towards you, right? Get it tight and then now roll it over. Good job, yo. Give Eva a round of applause. Look at that. Good job. Okay, so I'm going to ask you to stay up here. Okay? Let's move over and let, what was your name?
Eric.
Eric, thanks for coming up.
Oh, yeah.
So, let's do another one for you. Okay. So, same thing. We'll get some filling in there. Give that a try. So lift it up till the filling folds over. Yep. And then use your hands and pull it back. Right? So try to pull the wrapper back too. Right? Okay. And then kind of like use your fingers, kind of like pack it in. There you go. And then this, fold it over like that. There you go. And then same thing, pack it, flip it over once, and then keep going. Try to keep it packed in there, and then water, okay? Hold it up and show everybody. There you go. Okay, and what is your name?
Taylor.
Taylor, nice to meet you. So, let's see. You've seen it twice already, so I think you should be good to go, right? As you guys are doing that, I'm gonna start frying some of these. How's it going? Okay, so now, fold it kind of like an envelope.
Yeah.
So tighten it up right here. And then fold it over.
That's what I was doing.
Yeah, and pull it like that. See how it kind of gets tight, and then try to use your fingers to kind of pack it, and then start rolling. Okay, so as she's doing that, I'm gonna start on this caviar. A lot of people think that when you make caviar, let's hold it up. Let's show everybody what you did. There you go. All right, everybody give them a round of applause. You guys stay in the front, make sure so that I can see you guys. You guys will be the first to eat, okay? All right, so I'm gonna keep going on my demo here. And you guys can go down if you want. Or you can stay up here and be my helpers the rest of the time. Yeah? Okay, do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a soy sauce caviar. So to every cup of liquid is 2 teaspoons of this powder here. This is called agar-agar. You can buy it at all Asian stores. It's basically a powder that's made out of seaweed. And it's an alternative version to using gelatin because gelatin is actually not vegetarian. Gelatin is made out of bone marrow and animal proteins and stuff like that. So if you eat something with jelly or gelatin and you're a vegetarian, you're not really a vegetarian. So you have to leave. Eve, thank you for coming up and helping, okay? You know what? I'm gonna give you one of these. Thank you. Everybody give Eve a round of applause. Okay, so let's get this going here. So 1 cup of liquid, like diluted with water, and we're gonna get it boiling on a pot of water. And we're gonna put about 2 teaspoons of this powder into here. Pass me one of those forks, please. You want to be on fryer duty? You can be on fryer duty. Just wait. Just kind of shake it around and like let it cook.
Okay.
Move them around and see till they get a little bit more golden brown than that.
Okay.
And then that's yours. And what was your name again?
Taylor.
Okay. So you're going to help me with this. So once that starts to boil, the key to making caviar is you have to have oil to drop in the liquid to, but the oil has to be cooled. So what I do is I put it in this container and then I'll put it in the freezer. The trick with that is that as soon as the hot liquid hits the oil, it will solidify, right? So here already you could see how it's already thick, right? See how it's thickening there, right? So that's already gotten to a boil. So let's turn that off, and that's good to go. My sister's a nurse, so I just steal syringes from her house. You can do this with a squeeze bottle or anything like that. If the camera can kind of zoom in on this oil here, it'll show you on the big screen the process and the technique of making caviar. So like I said before, you can do caviar with any type of liquid you can think of. You just have to boil it and disintegrate this powder into it, and then put it into a vessel like this syringe here. And then you just have to drop it into this liquid. So do you see how it's hitting the oil, and then it's dropping to the bottom of the container, but very slowly? As it's falling down, it's changing from a liquid into a solid. And you'll never get perfect circles the same size every time, because it's just how it is. It's imperfect, right? And that's the whole point. But you could make different things like this, different colors, like a strawberry puree with a little bit of water. You'll have red caviar. I did a dinner the other week, and I did green onions with water, and it was a nice, like, green caviar on top of scallops. So this is kind of just the technique of how to do that. You want to give it a try? So you just got to squeeze it in, move it around. Okay, I think those are looking good. Okay. So we're gonna move some of these over, right. And we're going to refry these ones, get them hot again.
Those ones?
Yeah. Okay. So let's get that. Dump those into here. Nice job. There you go. So drop that right back in there. Let's get these in there. So here I'm kind of just refrying ones that I already prepared. I knew that I was going to have a little bit of time, and I wouldn't be able to cook all of these in the span of 30 minutes. So egg rolls will always get soggy as they sit. But there's nothing wrong with refrying an egg roll. So, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So how's it going? Okay. Let's get that in there, and then we'll do a test. There you go. So who's ever seen this method of making caviar before? Anybody? Show of hands, who here has ever eaten Filipino food? Filipino food is like lumpia, pancit, adobo, things like that. So a lot of people don't realize that Filipino food is a mixture of three different types of cuisines. So it's a mixture of Spanish food, Americanized food, and Chinese food. So all of those influences sandwiched into one cuisine, which I feel like makes our cuisine different from everybody else's. So see how this kind of just solidified still? That means that the oil wasn't cold enough. There will be obviously some pieces in here that will be good to go, but luckily I'm a professional and I made some beforehand. So let's see how these looking. Okay, those are good. Let's pull those out. If you can just continue on with this. Sorry, what was your name again? Taylor. So I'm going to show you guys something. This is a traditional way of making a papaya salad. This is the traditional way to do it in Southeast Asia. It's very hands-on. This is the way that I make it. So papaya salad, that's this right here. This is seasoned with sesame oil, rice wine vinegar, and red Thai chili. So it's a little bit spicy, but hopefully you guys will still like it. So this is the traditional way to make it. So take your knife in your hand, preferably use a towel to hold on to the papaya, but you're just gonna do this. So traditionally, this is how it's done in Southeast Asia, Thailand, Laos, Philippines. And then, so you make all these cuts in the side of a papaya. On the inside, the center of this is full of seeds. So you don't want to go all the way through till you get to the point where you're at the seeds. Basically, you just want to get the flesh of it. Then you take a slicer or a paring knife, and then you do this. So with that technique, you get all these uneven little cuts. And I mean, some people will cut this, like other chefs will cut this into little thin strips and then julienne it. This is a quick all the way around, right? And you just go around like this. Done, right? See how fast that is? I could do this whole thing and maybe like five more in like 20 minutes, not even. And I could fill up maybe five of these in the matter of 10 minutes. So how's it going over there? Okay, so I just wanted to show you guys a few techniques of how to do things. Now I think what the three of us are gonna do is, let me clean this off. Does anybody know how much time I have left? No? Okay. Okay. So, let's start plating. You guys want to come and help me plate? Okay. So this is what we're going to do. Let's move this over here. Okay. So, I should have brought another cutting board. But, so what I want you guys to do, or one of you to do, cut it on a bias, right? I'm gonna go start with this, or one of you can start with this. And you can start hitting each of these plates. Small little handful, like that, a papaya salad. Can leave you with that. Okay, and let's get you cutting these. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to the fryer and fry these ones that you forgot to fry. A half for every portion. So perfect. Looks good. So let's do this, guys, okay? Put it right on top of the papaya. Okay, so as she's plating here, I'm gonna follow her and top each of these lumpias with the soy sauce caviar that I made last night. Let's switch spots. Looking good. No, it's all good, man. How about you just help her plate? Does anybody have any questions for me while we're plating up here for you guys? Anybody? No? What's up? Caviar? Caviar is basically fish eggs. Like real caviar is fish eggs. So fish babies. This is not. We just made it. So it's made out of soy sauce and water and agar-agar. It's supposed to mimic caviar, but it's not real caviar. Real caviar would be like baby fish. Yeah. Okay, so since that's all done, how about you go and put like this much on each one, and then you follow behind her. This will be the finishing. So you can put like Five minutes? Okay. Yep. You know, I've been cooking for quite a long time. I've been cooking more seriously for about 9 years. I started cooking when my mom passed away from cancer. I wanted to recreate all of the dishes that she used to make. So I started cooking in 2008 when she passed away, and then just more seriously since 2010. So I'm a self-taught chef, and I've taught everything that I know. Like, everything that I know, I've taught myself. But yeah, I would say a good 6-7 years. I feel like I'm faster with my hands. I'm gonna use my hands. Do you want to follow along and put some lumpia on each one? And then we'll go back to that caviar right away. We have 5 minutes, guys. I am, actually. So if you can finish those ones with the caviar and then the greens after. And all right, so if you guys want, you guys can start coming up here and grabbing some food. Whoa. Here, guys.
Thank you.
So if you want to help me pass them out. Oh, there's forks right there if you guys want forks. Here you go, man. Here you go, man. Here you go. Here you go. Those ones need caviar.
I kind of put the stuff on it before I realized.
That's okay. Good. My apron? I got my apron online. It's at a company from BC called Search and Rescue Denim. Yeah. Okay. The wrappers? You can get the wrappers at any Asian stores here in Winnipeg, so Young's, Lucky, and it's in the refrigerated frozen section. Yeah. Okay, guys, I know we have a little bit less than 5 minutes here, but we are almost done. And hopefully everybody will get a chance to eat. Hi. Right after this. Yeah, you two get to eat a full portion. Okay, so let's go along. What was that?
It needs the stuff on the green stuff.
Oh, okay. Even if it's okay if it's not doesn't have it. We're running out of time here, so.
Are you okay with that stuff?
Yeah. I mean the green stuff that we're putting on it is it's called micro arugula. So arugula picked before it's even fully grown or whatever. But
Chef.
Yeah. Okay. So we have a few more portions to go and we're almost done. That's okay. Whoever wants seconds, come up and get some. Oh yeah, I'm making you guys a portion right now. Yeah, you can taste it. It's really good. Oh, I already made them a bigger plate than everybody else. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more to go. So let's lay out 7 more of these. Perfect. Okay. There you go. Oh, wait, that's 7.
You don't.
You just leave them with the oil, or you can dump them out on a paper towel and let it kind of drain off that way. But other than that, I usually just take it directly out of the container. I strain the oil off of it, and then I'll just do it from there. So. Okay, so that wraps up my presentation, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the food. And everybody give Eric and Taylor a big round of applause for being my sous chefs today. Thank you guys so much for helping out.
Yeah.